So let's begin with our chapter and our topics. Very first topic in our chapter is what do you mean by management? So whatever you think management is something to resource, to manage some resources or some people or like that, this is not only the management. What is actually the management? Management is the process or any sequential activities which can be performed in an efficient and effective manner. Now we have to discuss what I am telling about, what is the process and what is efficient and what is effectiveness, what is it it's all about. In this our definition, we need to understand three main areas. Let's see the definition. What is the definition? Management can be defined as the process of getting things done with the aim of achieving goals effectively and efficiently. So in this we need to discuss three words in main areas. First word is what do you mean by process? Second word is what is efficiently? And third word is what do you mean by efficiently? Okay. So according to you, what is process? What do you mean by process? Generally we thought about process is something like sequential activities or a sequence of activities or anything which can be done in a sequence, right? So let's understand what do you mean by process. First we need to understand what is process. In our subject you need to bring your books as well as your notes as well as your registers also, so that whatever I'll write in your board you will write in your registers, as well as whatever examples I will give or whatever the topic I'll teach you, if you think you need to write or pen it down, then please write that, so that it will be very well helpful to you in your revisions. Now so first topic is process. What do you mean by process? What I told you about, that process is a sequence of activities. Sequence of activities or work performed. Work performed in a sequence. Or a work performed in a sequence. What is it all about? Let's discuss about some examples of process. What does that mean? Sequence of activities? Really? What is this? Suppose we are going for a shopping purpose. Okay. Now, what do you think, whenever you go for a shopping, there are two options. Either you have to go at a particular shop, bring a particular dress and come at home. This is what generally we guys do. But there is a second option of shopping too. What is that? You have to go for all different shops. You will look out about different varieties of clothes in every shop. Then you are trying to bargaining them. Then you are finalizing them, the which is the most comfortable dress or most suitable dress you suits, which suits you. Thereafter, you will offer your demanding price, what you want to purchase in that price. Thereafter, you will deal with the bargaining process with your seller. Is it or not? Yes. You will bargain with your seller that please give some discount, or we have to maintain our relations, I'll keep in future, I'll send my friends. So you do bargaining like that in your daily life. Thereafter, if seller accepts your proposal, then he or she will bargain your price, then you have to pay him her, his price. Thereafter, is your work is over yet? No. You need to first check, as well as you need to show at your family also, is the dress best suitable to me or not. Thereafter, if your family suggests that it is the best for you, then it's completely fine, we took this dress. But whenever your family or friends said you that this dress don't suits you or doesn't makes you comfortable or something like that, then you will again go to your shopkeeper and ask to refund or change the dress. Is it happens with everyone? Yes or no? Yes. This is also a example of process. What is the process is here? First we go to the shopkeeper. Second process, we find out the some dresses. Third process, we bargaining with the shopkeeper. All things are interrelated. You can't do any one thing before or after anything. So thereafter, whenever you bargain your dress for your dress, then you had to pay your amount. Then after your amount, you need to give his or her feedback about the dress, whether that dress is suitable for me or not. This is all about completely related with the process. Second word, what I have marked you is that second word we need to understand is effectively. What do you mean by effectively? And one more word I have marked is efficiently. So let's discuss about these words. Next word is your here effectively. Effectively means to completing your task or an activity, or to achieve a goal, to set a target and achieve a goal. In short, we need to learn this about to complete a task or activities. Like for example, you are working at some company and the boss of this company told you that you need to sell 1000 units per month. That is your target, that you need to sell 1000 units. Or I can say your boss told you that you need to prepare or buy 1000 units for whole month. If he or she ask about your manufacturing, that you need to manufacture or produce 1000 units, that is your target. You have to complete your target. And this is called effectiveness, that 1000 products produced, this is called effectiveness. But is there any time limit required when you have to produce, as well as any cost required? Or else you will say that you told me na ki aapne bola tha 1000 units karne, 1000 units karne. So I made the 1000 units, but I will do in overtime, so my cost will incur in a very own manner. I'll have to pay double shifts to my labor. This is not the your doing the work as in utilizing the resources in an optimum manner. That's why we use the word efficiency. Two words are there, effectively means to completing the task, and next word is efficiency. Efficiency here represents with the to minimize your cost or to give best utilization of resources. To complete any task at minimal cost or utilizing minimal cost or utilizing
utilizing your resources
in an optimum manner.
Resources in an optimum manner.
In an optimum manner. Let's discuss this with an example. Suppose, let's take the same example. Your boss told you to manufacture 1000 products. Now you are manufacturing 1000 products and taking your time as a your boss asked to prepare it in 1 month or suppose 15 days. And you are preparing that whole the production in 1 month, no doubt in that. You do a very well job and you think that you impress your boss. But what mistake you have done is that your boss asked you to prepare this whole production 1000 units in normal working hours, not on overtime working hours, or don't need any extra labors or any extra timing or any extra resources for that. You have to manage your resources only with whatever you have given. So whenever you go with your boss and say, sir, I had completed my work, we finished 1000 units of production, but whenever he asked you how much it will cost you, suppose your manager already know it will cost around 1 lakh rupees for production on in general, but you incurred cost of rupees 1 lakh 10,000, is he or she gonna be happy or gonna fire you or something like that action? Ki nahi bhai, whatever you are doing, something like that. So if he was targeting about the amount 1 lakh na, then if you had completed your work in time, saving your cost, and did your completed your production within 1 lakh, for example 95,000, then I am sure your manager will be most proud of you, as well as it is a very good opportunity to get a promotion and get a appreciation in all your company. So what we all do is that we need to manage our resources. And whatever I told in management, that is, management is a process of doing some activity in an effective and efficient manner. Means you have to manage all kind of processes with the help of efficiency and effectiveness. How it can be managed with the efficiency and effectiveness? Efficiency generally deals with the resources, how you utilize your resources, as well as effectively deals with how you completed your task, as well as how you will achieve your target. It all depends upon effectively. Let's discuss some example also. Here we are, just do the first simple reading. Efficiency means doing the task correctly at minimum cost, we had already discussed, while effectiveness means completing the task correctly, to doing the task in a correct manner. Although efficiency and effectiveness are different, but they are interrelated. Yes, this is also thing, both are interrelated. Efficiency and effectiveness are interrelated. As I said earlier, you completed your target, you completed your production is not the only thing. You have to complete your transactions or productions within time limit, within cost, and as well as save to all resources. Okay. Thereafter, it is important for management to be both effective and efficient. What we think is the manager or management should be work performed only if he is efficient or only if he is effective? No, he can't. He need to be efficient and effective. Okay, thereafter I had made you a, given you an example. Let's check this, what's it's all about. A business produces targeted 1000 units but at a higher cost, is effective but not an efficient. As I said, 1000 units you are making and you are taking a cost around 1,10,000 rupees. Higher cost is 1,10,000. It is not an efficient way to do a business. Therefore, if the business has to be effective and efficient, then it has to produce 1000 units within cost. What do you mean by within cost?
Here we means within cost means what I told you.
Within cost, what I told you that you need to complete your production within 1 lakh, or I said what amount? 95,000. You need to complete your whole production in 95,000, so that your business will be done in an efficient and effective manner. Okay,